Well, with Election Day less than 4 weeks away, the issue of trans participation in sport has become a heated political talking point. The debate has led to Victoria's Premier Daniel Andrews today slamming federal Liberal MPs and candidates campaigning against trans women in female sport.
Seems to me that the adults in this debate are altogether more cruel than the kids. And that's a damning indictment on those who are pushing this. Because I've been in the Parliament for 20 years and I've never had a school community come to me and raise this issue. I've never had a parent come to me. I never had a teacher come to me and raise this issue.
Well, the Premier noted many sporting bodies already have protocols for trans people to compete at professional and amateur levels, and that includes grassroots footy. Well, Elsternwick Amateur Football Club has officially welcomed players of all identities and backgrounds, including trans people, since 2018. And the club's Vice President, Stephanie Convery, joins us right now. Stephanie, the issue of trans inclusion is obviously incredibly complex. Often it's very personal too. How do you as a club go navigating all of that?
I think the really important thing is that there's a lot of guidance available for clubs. So Sport Australia have a really robust policy around how to do trans inclusion in your club. There's a lot of myth busting in there, and there are a lot of myths that circulate around trans inclusion. The other thing is that in each league, there's usually a particular policy around how to do it for that particular sport. So the Victorian Amateur Football Association, which is the league that I play under, they have a policy of trans inclusion that means that trans men can play for the men's teams, trans women can play for the women's teams, and non-binary people can play for the teams in which they feel the most comfortable.
So, Stephanie, when you hear politicians suggest that sporting clubs like yours are struggling with transgender inclusion, I mean, are you?
No. I mean, the only places I think where people struggle is when they don't know what the right thing to do is. And I think what I would say to those clubs is reach out to the rest of us. There are other clubs who have done it before who are further along in their journey than you might be, who will help you do this. I mean, I had some great conversations with some clubs this week. West Brunswick is a great example of that. They're a few years ahead of us at Elsternwick, but they had some amazing suggestions for the things that we could do better. And every club is on a journey, right? Like, these are, for some clubs, it's new. For others, you know, they're a bit more practiced, but it opens up the entire place to the community. I mean, I cannot speak more highly of the positive effects for a sporting organisation to saying, like, to the community, you are all welcome. It doesn't matter who you are.
It seems this is something that is potentially being put forward as an election issue. What advice would you give to people who, as we move forward, maybe would be having conversations or even debates about this, how they can go about that without adding to the division?
I mean, I don't think this is a matter that needs to be debated right now. I mean, sport is across this issue. Like, we have been across this issue for a long time, and we are getting better and better at managing inclusion every day. We don't need this to be a political debate, and we don't need more legislation around this stuff. What we need is the space to get on with being inclusive, get on with community building. And I mean, if people really want to help women's sport, because that is the way that this debate is being framed around saving women's sport, they could put more money into facilities, that like change rooms so that people don't have to change in front of each other, shower blocks that are separate from the men's shower blocks. They could support the development of those clubs. There are so many other things that they could be doing, not marginalising an already marginalised group, a tiny group within that community.
Stephanie, thanks very much for talking to us tonight.
Thank you so much for having me.